put one on the engine and one on the ambulance, and maybe we can do some good with it.
Somebody did a special favor for the Windsor Heights Fire Department. They made an anonymous donation that could save the lives of cats and dogs.
And ferrets and rabbits and birds and just about any kind of household pet you could think of. Sounds a little like Dr. Doolittle stuff. Steve Karlin, tell us more.
Yeah, it does, Kevin. Now, when firefighters arrive on the scene of a fire, first, they rescue humans. Second, they bring the fire under control. Third, they protect property. And then, if necessary, they save pets. This gift will help them do that much better.
Four, like in this story at a mobile home park on Des Moines' south side, shot in 2002 by News Channel 8 Director of Photography, Courtney Kinson. In a fire, once the humans are safe and the scene is secure, firefighters will go to great lengths to save even the tiniest life.
Personally, I've not run across the situation.
But now, if he or any of his 28 firefighters ever do...
I don't know if any but other fire departments have this type of equipment.
Windsor Heights Fire Chief Christopher Cross has some specially designed oxygen masks.
The kit comes with three different sizes of masks based on the size of animal.
That will help them better help household pets that have inhaled too much smoke.
Slide the animal's muzzle in the mask and just give a mechanical ventilation like we would a human.
Up to now, the department has only carried masks that are made for humans. And as you can see, that's pretty nice for me, but it's less than perfect for a pet.
We get a great seal over the muzzle of the animal to more effectively control the airway.
Great seal.
It kind of hit me out of the blue.
And when your department depends on tax dollars,
I want to guesstimate about $75 per kit.
A great deal.
Generous donation from an anonymous source, someone that lives here in the community, bought two kits for us.
Yeah.
Windsor Heights firefighters now able to breathe life back into the littlest of the lifeless better.
They just received the masks on Monday, and the firefighters will all be taught how to properly use them next week.
And just to be clear here, Steve, the Windsor Heights Department isn't operating some sort of animal ambulance service or something.
That's a very good question, Kevin. No, they are not. They are not certified veterinarians. The masks will only be used on animals hurt in house fires after all the human life and people's property are preserved. Nice gift, though, from that anonymous donor.
It really is. Thanks, Steve.